Good morning, children. In the last lecture, we have discussed some points related to adolescence, puberty, the changes brought at puberty. We'll continue with that lecture only. And we are switching on to the chemical coordination in animals. That is chemical coordination in animals. This means what? This means the role of hormones responsible for maintaining the coordination in animals' body. Now, coordination in animals is brought about by the secretions of endocrine glands. Secretions of endocrine glands. These endocrine glands are ductless glands which secrete their chemical substance called as hormones, which are poured directly into the blood. Any chemical substance which is formed in the tissues of endocrine glands and are carried by the blood to other parts of the body for its specific actions is termed as hormone. An organ which responds to such a hormone is known as target organ. Let us discuss some things about, some important points about these hormones and their characteristics. The first important characteristic of hormone is these are called as the secretions of endocrine glands. Second, they are produced at a place and act on target organs which are mainly away from their source. Act on target organs. The third important characteristic about the hormone is they are poured directly into the blood. Put directly into the blood. Fourth important characteristic is they are required in very small quantities. Next important thing about them is they are very much specific in function. And chemically they are proteins only. Chemically they are proteins. And they are very much harmful if present in excess quantities. In excess, they are harmful. Now, let us discuss something about the various types of endocrine glands. So, various endocrine glands in human body. First important endocrine gland is called as pituitary gland. It is also called as hypophysis. Second important gland is called as pineal gland. Third important gland is thyroid. Fourth one is called as parathyroid. Fifth one is called as thymus gland. Sixth important gland is called as adrenal. Seventh important gland is pancreas. Eighth one is the ovaries, which is also a primary sex organ of females. And the ninth one is testes, which is a primary sex organ in case of males. Now let us discuss in detail about these endocrine glands. First we are going to take pituitary gland. Pituitary gland is also called as a master gland. It is a small ovoid structure which is attached at the base of the brain. Pituitary gland is also known as master gland, as I told you, because it controls other endocrine glands. Now, what are the main hormones of the pituitary gland? The main hormones, out of the main hormones, first hormone is called as growth hormone. This is also called as GH. This hormone promotes and regulates the process of growth. It promotes and regulates the growth process in our body. Its deficiency during childhood leads to dwarfism. Deficiency leads to a disease that is called as dwarfism. And its oversecretion leads to gigantism. Now next important hormone of the pituitary is thyroid stimulating hormone. thyroid stimulating hormone. This can also be called as TSH. It stimulates the growth and function of thyroid gland. Function of thyroid gland. The third important hormone of pituitary is melanocyte stimulating hormone, which can also be called as MSH. It controls the growth and development of melanocytes responsible for skin color. It regulates melanocytes. And melanocyte is a pigment which is responsible for skin color. The fourth important hormone of the pituitary gland is antidiuretic hormone, or it can be called as vasopressin. This causes the reabsorption of water into the blood from the collecting tubules of kidney. So this is responsible for reabsorption of water from kidney tubules. Antidiuretic hormone can also be called as vasopressin. Now let us come to the next important gland, that is pineal gland. Pineal gland is a small gland, reddish gray in color, about the size of a pea. It is attached to the roof of the brain. It contributes the development of gonads, that is, we can say it regulates gonadal development. Next important gland, which is endocrine gland, is thyroid gland. Thyroid gland is situated in the lower part of the neck. And when enlarged, it forms goiter. The hormone which is secreted by thyroid gland is called as thyroxine. The main role of thyroxine is to increase the metabolic rate. It increases the metabolic rate of the organs and tissues of the whole body. Thyroxine consists of iodine, an element which is essential to the gland to enable it to synthesize its hormone. The basal metabolic rate is increased in hyperthyroidism. In case of hyperthyroidism, BMR, which is called as a basal metabolic rate, it increases. And in hypothyroidism, basal metabolic rate decreases. So this was all about the thyroxine hormone, which is secreted by the thyroid gland. Now let us come to the next important gland, that is parathyroid gland. These are small ovoid glands, smaller than the size of pea. They lie on the posterior surface of the thyroid gland. Parathyroid gland has a secretion of hormone that is called as parathormone. This parathormone has two functions. First function for parathormone is it regulates the balance of calcium in bones. And second important function of parathormone is it controls the excretion of phosphates in the urine. Which are important salts in urine. Now next comes thymus gland. Thymus gland is situated in the thorax under the sternum. Sternum is also called as a chest bone, children. in front of trachea. It secretes a hormone that is called as thymosin. Thymosin is the name of the hormone secreted by thymus gland. This helps in producing, it produces antibodies to fight against infections. Next important gland is adrenal gland. These are two small semilunar structures, these are two in number, which lie on the upper side of each kidney. Upper side of, or instead of side, we can use upper pole of each kidney. That is why they are also known as suprarenal glands. The hormones secreted by adrenal glands are two in number. These two hormones are, first is called as adrenaline and the other hormone is called as noradrenaline. These two hormones are called as stress hormones because they lead to increase in systolic blood pressure, dilation of coronary blood vessels, increased sweating and increase in metabolic rate when individual is in some distress. Same is the case with non-adrenaline, it is a general vasoconstrictor, both systolic and diastolic pressures are increased. Both of these hormones help to pass through emergency conditions, so they are also called as fight or flight hormones. They are called as fight or flight hormones. Next important gland, endocrine gland, is pancreas. Pancreas is the only heterocrine gland in human body. It is situated near the liver. Hormones of the pancreas are, first, it secretes a hormone that is called as insulin, which is secreted by some special cells which are called as islets of Langerhans, and it is required to convert glucose into glycogen so that glucose in the form of glycogen can be stored in the body, and this process is called as glycogenesis. Second hormone secreted by pancreas is called as glucagon. It causes breakdown of liver glycogen, thereby releasing glucose into the bloodstream. So it will do what? It will convert glycogen into glucose. So these are the two hormones of the pancreas gland. Next important endocrine gland is ovaries. Ovaries are two in number. They are present in females only. They are situated in the pelvic region of lower abdomen of females. Hormones secreted by ovaries are as follows: estrogen and progesterone. Estrogen affects the development of female secondary sex characters. Development of female secondary sex characters, and progesterone prepares the uterus for receiving the embryo. So this is also responsible for maintenance of pregnancy. So it is called as a pregnancy hormone. Next and last important endocrine gland is testes, which is present only in males. It is also called as a male genital organ. These are also two in number, situated outside the lower abdomen. Outside the lower abdomen. It secretes only one hormone that is called as testosterone. It is mainly concerned with the development and maintenance of male sex characters. Development and maintenance of male sex characters and enhancing the process of spermatogenesis. Let us discuss something about the role of hormones in initiating reproductive function. Actually, children, endocrine glands release hormones into the bloodstream to reach a particular body part called as target site. Hormones are released in the blood and they reach to what? Target site. Now this target site responds to the hormone. It responds to the hormone. There are many endocrine glands or ductal glands in the body. The testes and ovaries secrete sex hormones. These hormones are responsible for the male and female secondary sexual characters. Further, the sex hormones are under the control of hormones from the pituitary gland. Pituitary secretes many hormones, one of which stimulates the maturation of ovum in ovaries and sperms in testes. So ultimately, pituitary is called as a master gland, which is controlling the secretions of other endocrine glands. So this completes your adolescence chapter, children. Thank you.